Hello, everybody. Good afternoon. It's your State Senator, Paul Ciccarella, coming to you from my North Haven office here in District. Unfortunately, I have not been up at the Capitol as much as I'd like due to, obviously, our COVID restrictions and some inclement weather. We've been working remotely. I'm sure everybody is aware of the new normal, which are these Zoom meetings. And that's how we as legislators have been conducting our business. I cannot wait to get back to normal. I'm sure everybody else feels the same way. These Zoom meetings can be pretty taxing on the eyes and the mind. Looking forward to getting back to being in person to have these type of meetings, even to be talking to you, my constituents. Cannot wait. But we are still conducting business. We're holding our screening and committee meetings via Zoom. And our committee meetings are open to the public. Normally, we would be up at the Capitol and you'd be able to come there or view it on CTN, but you could still view it on CTN or on YouTube. And I'll make sure on my website, we'll get you the information or the links to be able to view the committee meetings that I would be attending, as well as other committee meetings for your review. Just a recap, you know, I am a ranking member on Veterans Affairs as well as Housing. I also am a member of the Public Safety and Appropriations Committee as well. So we deal with a lot of different topics within each of those committees. And part of what we're doing right now is screening some of the proposed bills. And you can see some of what comes out of screening in those committee meetings that are available both on YouTube and CTN. While you're watching those, if you do have any questions, concerns that comes up on any of the committees I'm on or any other committees, please feel free to reach out and ask me any questions or give us some insight or opinions. As I stated before, some of the best way I've learned about what's going on here in District is talking to people. So I do encourage you to reach out anytime. Again, my information will be below the bottom and you can get a hold of me through email, phone call, or through the website, and I'll be happy to set up a time to talk with you. I've been taking a lot of constituent meetings, both phone calls and Zooms, so I'd love to have some more. Hopefully soon we'll be able to get back together in person, face-to-face, and set up some type of a town hall or coffee hour. Looking forward to those times. Some of the stuff we've been doing here in District, I had the honor to review some capstone projects from the East Haven High School and was able to see some great projects, one of which was a project to raise money for the East Haven Police Canine Unit. It was for paws protection from one of the senior students. Keep a lookout on my social media and my website for more information about that. Such a great presentation. I'm trying to get involved and help out and raise some awareness. Such a great project amongst many other projects I had the opportunity to review. Working on some workforce development stuff with some of the schools. So hopefully we could be putting that together. Basically allowing some high school students to get some training that would allow them to come right out of high school and be able to get some really good paying jobs here in Connecticut, which will help some of the small businesses. Very excited about that. Also recently I was able to have a meeting with Commissioner Saudi, our Veterans Affairs Commissioner. And it was a great meeting. Got a bunch of information that will help me in my committee being ranking with Veterans Affairs, but more importantly, to be able to provide some answers and information to our local residents. Again, so if you have any concerns with any Veterans Affairs issues, please reach out. Also, one of the opportunities that I had the privilege of being a part of was being on the board or being a panelist to review some of the applications for the 2020 Veterans Hall of Fame. And over the course of a few nights, I had the opportunity to review over 50 applications for people who were nominated for the Veterans Hall of Fame. And one of the nominees was our East Haven own Felix Deljudis, East Haven resident. He was a hero. Very impressive, very, very impressive service record. Speaking from memory here, so I apologize if I miss any of his medals or citations or ribbons. There was so many. He had 2 Purple Hearts. He had 4 battle stars, meaning he was in 4 battles. Obviously, the Purple Hearts mean he was wounded in 2 of those 4 battles. 2 presidential unit citations. And he also had, I believe it was 8 other medals and ribbons. Very impressive. Very much involved in the town of East Haven, both for his volunteer work with the town and also his activism for other veterans. And there was many other veterans who applied that had very, very impressive resumes. So it was a privilege to be able to do that. As I was saying before, we are unfortunately unable to gather. So I do encourage for you guys to reach out in any way to be able to bring some of your concerns forward, maybe give me some advice, and allow me to represent you the best I can. I do look forward to speaking with everybody soon, hopefully in person. But until then, please feel free to reach out. Strongly encourage it. I have a great staff up at the Capitol that could assist me in getting you any information, whether it's regarding some of the vaccination processes and things that are going on with the COVID vaccinations, or if you're having an issue getting through to some state agencies. I know it could be a real challenge. Hopefully we could help you navigate the process and get you information that much faster. But please feel free, again, reach out anytime. And stay safe. I understand we have some inclement weather coming. So please stay safe and talk to you guys soon. Thank you.